One of the first things we want to talk about is actually how we send SQL to the database. Believe it or not, this is where a lot of programmers make a large amount of mistakes and give away literally orders of magnitude of performance. And in the demonstration, what we're going to show is we're going to show a very simple online gaming system application. And we're going to show it literally being coded at its most inefficient, and we're going to take it through to its most optimal performance. And you will notice that the performance jumps from about 300 transactions a second to over 40,000 transactions a second. Now, that sort of in performance gain cannot be achieved by just throwing hardware at the problem. This is a result of writing the applications properly and using the Oracle database in the manner that it was designed to be used, in the most efficient manner. And I can't emphasize this enough, because it isn't being taught at school, it's not being understood, and there are also side effects to doing things incorrectly that affect system availability, system security, and these are all extremely important. I cannot emphasize this enough, and this is just part of everyday life in real-world performance. We identify inefficiencies in people's applications, and there is always a large amount of reluctance to acknowledge it, go back and modify it and change code, and there's a motivation to think, well, surely you have some magic parameter to solve this problem. Well, I'm telling you, there aren't magic parameters within the Oracle database. Otherwise, we would have set them when you got the product, when it left the house. Okay? So it's all about learning how to use the product correctly. And in many cases, the audience of this video will know this already, but I'm going to challenge you and say, how many people, junior people within your organization, have you trained and coached and mentored to do this correctly since they joined your organization? And better still, have you put these sort of coding standards into the requirements when developing a new application? Have architects learn these things so that they can specify them